words there?
A friend.
Be on your way. This is my territory.
Your territory? What do you mean?
Wait a minute. It's you, the man from Maybury Hill.
Good heavens, the artillery man. I thought you surely burned.
I thought you surely drowned.
Have you seen any Martians?
Everywhere. We're done for, all right.
We can't just give up.
Of course we can't. It's now we've got to start fighting. Not against them, because we can't win. Now we've got to fight for survival. I reckon we can make it. I've got a plan. Clap eyes in us and we're dead, right? So we gotta make a new life where they'll never find us. You know where? Underground. You should see it down there. Hundreds of miles of drains. Sweet and clean now after the rain. Dark, quiet, safe. We can build houses and everything. Start again from scratch. And what's so bad about living underground, eh? It's not been so great living up here, if you want my opinion. Take a look around you at the world we've come to know. Does it seem to be much more than a crazy circus show? But maybe from the madness, something beautiful will grow in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again, all over again, all over again, all over again. And hospitals and barracks right under their noses, right under their feet. Everything we need, banks, prisons and schools. We'll send scouting parties to collect books and stuff, and men like you will teach the kids, not poems and rubbish, science, so we can get everything working. We'll build villages and towns and we'll play each other at cricket. Listen, maybe one day we'll capture a fighting machine, eh? Learn how to make them ourselves and then... wallop! Our turn to do some wiping out. Whoosh with our heat ray. Whoosh! And them running and dying. Beaten at their own game. Man on top! Domination of the earth is fading fast, and out of the confusion the chance has come at last to build a better future from the ashes of the past in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again. in cages of convention, from the cradle to the grave. The weak fall by the wayside, but the strong will be saved in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again. I'm not trying to tell you what to be. Oh no, not me. But if mankind is to survive, the people left alive, they're gonna have to build this world anew. And it's going to have to start with me and you. I'm not trying to tell you what to be. Oh no, not me. But if mankind is to survive, the people left alive, they're gonna have to build this world anew. Yes, and we will have to be the chosen few. Just think of all the poverty, the hatred and the lies, and imagine the destruction of all that you despise. Slowly from the ashes that phoenix will arise in a brave new world. With just a handful of men, we'll start all over again. Take a look around you at the world you've loved so well, and bid the aging empire of man a last farewell. It may not sound like heaven, but at least it isn't hell. It's a brave new world with just a handful of men. We'll start all over again. All over again. All over again. All over again. I've got a just see it? Civilization starting all over again. A second chance. We'll even build a railway and tunnel to the coast. Go there for our holidays. Nothing can stop men like us. I've made a start already. Come on down here, have a look.
In the cellar was a tunnel scarcely 10 yards long that had taken him a week to dig. I could have dug that much in a day. And I suddenly had my first inkling of the gulf between his dreams and his powers.
It's doing the working and the thinking that wears a fellow out. I'm ready for a bit of a rest. How about a drink, eh? Nothing but champagne, now I'm the boss.
We drank, and then he insisted upon playing cards. With our species on the edge of extermination, with no prospect but a horrible death, we actually played games. Later he talked more of his plan, but I saw flames flashing in the deep blue night, red weed glowing, tripod figures moving distantly, and I put down my champagne glass. I felt a traitor to my kind, and I knew I must leave this strange dreamer.
Take a look around you at the world we've come to know. Does it seem to be much more than a crazy circus show? Maybe from the madness something beautiful will grow.
A dozen dead bodies in the Euston Road, their outlines softened by the black dust. All was still, houses locked and empty, shops closed. But looters had helped themselves to wine and food, and outside a jeweler's, some gold chains and a watch were scattered on the pavement. Stopped, staring towards the sound. It seemed as if that mighty desert of houses had found a voice for its fear and solitude. Thank you. desolating cry worked upon my mind. The wailing took possession of me. I was intensely weary, footsore, hungry, and thirsty. Why was I wandering alone in this city of the dead? Why was I alive when London was lying in state in its black shroud? I felt intolerably lonely, drifting from street to empty street, drawn inexorably towards that cry. Primrose Hill, the fighting machine from which the howling came. I crossed Regent's Canal. There stood a second machine, upright, but as still as the first. Abruptly, the sound ceased. Suddenly the desolation, the solitude, became unendurable. While that voice sounded, London had still seemed alive. Now suddenly there was a change, the passing of something, and all that remained was this gaunt quiet. I looked up and saw a third machine. It was erect and motionless, like the others. An insane resolve possessed me. I would give my life to the Martians, here and now. I marched recklessly towards the Titan and saw that a multitude of black birds were circling and clustering about the hood. I began running along the road. I felt no fear, only a wild, trembling exultation as I ran up the hill towards the motionless monster. Out of the hood hung red shreds at which the hungry birds now pecked and tore. Crest of Primrose Hill, the Martians' camp was below me. A mighty space it was, and scattered about it in their overturned machines were the Martians, dead, slain after all man's devices had failed by the humblest things upon the earth. Bacteria, minute, invisible bacteria. Directly the invaders arrived and drank and fed, our microscopic allies attacked them. From that moment, they were doomed. still scattered over the country, desperate, leaderless, starved. The thousands who had fled by sea, including the one most dear to me. All would return. The pulse of life, growing stronger and stronger, would beat again. As life returns to normal, the question of another attack from Mars causes universal concern. Is our planet safe? Or is this time of peace merely a reprieve? It may be that across the immensity of space, they have learned their lessons and even now await their opportunity. Perhaps the future belongs not to us, but to the Martians.
Getting great pictures here at NASA Control Pasadena. The landing craft touched down on Mars 28 kilometers from the aim point. We're looking at a remarkable landscape, littered with different kinds of rocks, red, purple. How about that, Bermuda?
Fantastic. Look at that dune field.
Hey, wait, I'm getting a no-go signal. Now I'm losing one of the craft. Hey, Bermuda, you getting it?
Well, lost contact. A lot of dust blowing up there.
Now I lost the second craft. We got problems.
All contact lost, Pasadena. Maybe the antennas...
What's that flare? See it? A green flare coming from Mars. Kind of a green mist behind it. It's getting closer. You see it, Bermuda? Come in, Bermuda. Houston, come in. What's going on? Tracking station 43, Canberra. Come in, Canberra. Tracking station 63. Can you hear me, Madrid? Can anybody hear me? Come in. Come in.